Everyone, in this video I will be sharing with you how I painted this white peacock. This is actually one of my favorite paintings now. I just love to paint white in watercolors, white flowers or white birds. And when I saw this reference photo on unsplash.com, I just fell in love with it. I knew I had to paint it and I already had it in my mind how I would go about it. Because it's white, it can be a little tricky how to capture that white. So the true white in nature is not like bright white as we might think. It actually has some shade and colors to it. So we have to create those colors, those tones with our watercolors, and it's best to use very diluted paint to create those tones, very light colors. It doesn't actually have to be light color or light colors. You can use any colors, but it should be very transparent, on a transparent side. I wanted to do the background from the beginning, wet on wet, just to give that very soft effect. I already knew that I'm going to focus on the face the most and everything else is just gonna be loose. Again, this is the reference photo I got and I just loved it from the beginning and I knew I had to paint it, and I also added gold pigment to my watercolors. I love using gold because it adds that extra shimmery look to my paintings. This pencil sketch is available for download. And these are the brushes I used in this painting, for this painting. So flat stroke 3/4, liner 2, round 1, heritage series. All these three brushes, the red ones. And I guess the middle one is also red, but it's actually Velvet Touch series. And this one is Chisel Blender 6. I use this one to lift up. And then one of my most used brushes recently, it's the Aqua Elite series, Long Round 8. And I use this brush a lot because it does have a pointy end, long pointy end. So I use it instead of sometimes just having two different brushes. I use this one because it has this bigger head and then at the end this long thin end, so it's like having an extra smaller brush. These are all the colors I used in this painting, and please don't worry if you don't paint with whole my watercolors. It's just a personal preference. You are welcome to paint with any other brand. This is just a list of colors and you can try to find alternatives, or you can go with the same ones, or you don't even have to use the same ones, the same colors or color tones. You can come up with your own colors. So totally up to you. This is just an example of what I like to use, what I used. And these are some of my top colors, especially when I paint white, like white fur, white flowers, lots of light tones like I pretty much always use yellow ochre, and then I like to mix in gold, and then I have quinacridone red. So quinacridone red and yellow ochre are like my perfect mix of colors together, and I use that a lot. Also neutral tint, which is not a gray color, but it's on the warmer side. And then Van Dyke Brown. I love Van Dyke Brown as an addition, and then Burnt Sienna. I did wanted to add some blue. There's definitely blue in it, and I used cobalt blue. Thank you.